Garcia. And his nominator, Tom Martinez, is here. So if you guys could both come up. And Gus, would you like to come up?
Had a profound impact on students and on the development of CSUB. Dr. Garcia, I guess, had a profound impact on the field of education, especially in this region, particularly on students, teachers, and educational administrators. His career at CSUB actually spanned a total of 42 years. He began in the early days of the campus in 1972, and he finished up with his regular retirement in 2009. And finished out his work in 2014. He was gone for a short time in the late 70s and 80s as he left to University of the Pacific to go teach there. And there he headed up, in addition to other duties, headed up a Title VII doctoral program, which received national honor. But in addition to that, prior to all of his higher ed work, he actually was an elementary school teacher, teaching from kindergarten to sixth graders back in the 1960s. So his full career as a devoted educator really spans 50 years. It's hard to tell. He started when he was 12. But, as I did. But anyway, I'll just say then that in terms of our, what was the School of Education, talk about that some other day. But in our School of Education, he served in the departments of teacher education, advanced educational studies, and ed administration. He's had been a special role in offering leadership and inspiration to local teachers, educational administrators, and serving especially the large population of English learners and bilingual children in the San Joaquin Valley. His professional focus has always been on teaching as you would like to be taught, to not convey just the content of the field, but to treat the student respectfully and to develop the whole person, to assure that each of his students care about their students and about learning. I don't want to get too big on the list of his accomplishments. I'll just briefly say that he headed up our multi-subject and bilingual credential programs. He was the director of elementary education and student teaching programs. He brought to the campus over $3 million in federal grants that went to support students to attend CSUB and to support some special initiatives. I'll just say that when I was completing the nomination, I let the word out to a few people that I knew that I was going to be nominating Gus, and if anybody wanted to add on, let me know. And I had a number of faculty who allowed me to add their names to the list of nominees, and then began to receive letters from some of the former students who were saying, I understand Gus is being nominated for this award, we want to comment. So some of those students are actually here. Janie Flores is the director of migrant education for our entire region. She's a former student of Gus. But so students sent their comments, and there was half dozen letters or more that came in and kind of say, and quote from all of them or anything. I'll just say that a couple of quotes is one student mentioned that he empowered us to be strong leaders and learners. He paced the room like a preacher, preaching higher ed and preaching education for all. I'll just, that'll introduce guests. one of my mentors, and of many others, too.
Trained us as our secretary in our three federally funded programs. She was the backbone and the soft shoulder students could go to, Tanya Walker. I'm serious about his covering all the bases, so I'm just going to try to cut through a few things. Most of the work that we did as a team. You know, I was in the right place at the right time. When I arrived on campus in 72, there was already a wonderful program going on, and it was the Mini-Corps program. And John Acosta was the director, was at the helm. John passed away a few years ago, but his legacy continues with the Mini-Corps program. Would be remiss not to mention him. At the time that Dr. Kallenberger and I and other people were developing the mobile subjects program for the first time, John was there to work with me, along with the Mini-Corps, worked with me to develop the bilingual emphasis, which we built into that original program. That became very important later on. We were also getting a lot of help from Bakersfield College. There was a man over there who has a legacy of his own. His name was Manuel Gonzalez, best counselor BC ever had. He sends thousands of students, many students that probably would not have graduated from BC without his personal assistance. He was the father, he passed away a few years ago, but he was the father of Andre Gonzalez, who's becoming very well known locally. I was teaching and directing an elementary education for 8 years when Dr. Luis Wildman, was helpful in helping me to transfer to another department where I was able to work more in elementary, more in bilingual education. And there were just a number of people I want to mention that played an important role in each of those programs. One of them is Patricia Rice. In the Kern County Superintendent of Schools office. We jointly wrote that first federal grant. Dr. Debbie Hirai, who is emeritus now here, who is living in Nevada, she worked with me to develop the CLAD and BCLAD certificate program. Nella Gonzalez, whose students could go to when they couldn't put up with me anymore, you know, they'd get a lot of help from her. She was one of our teachers. Another person who came here is a brand new faculty member, was Dr. Frank Espinosa. He is a star up there in San Jose now, at one of the community colleges up there. When he came, he was a new guy on the block, but he knew an awful lot about technology, helped Tanya and helped me, and he helped me write that second grant, and that was the Becker grant, which brought undergrads to us. Dr. Lewis Wildman's assistance was always there. First of all, he encouraged and supported me in the preparation of the MA program, and then the third grant as well. These are people who carried the load, really were very helpful. Without them, it would not have been possible. Now, Dr. Martinez mentioned that some of our former students are here, And I'd like to, you know, hold your applause, but I do want them to be recognized. First one I want to mention, first of all, in John Acosta's program, the Mini Corps program, I would say that virtually every graduate from the Mini Corps, program turned out to be an excellent educator. They're all over the place. Al Capilla, for example, became assistant superintendent of Bakersfield City School District. Joe Capilla was an administrator in Wasco. Refugio Martinez was a principal in Wasco. I can just go on and on. Frank Chavez, the one that everyone thought was going to fail, ended up being superintendent in Richland, Richgrove School District. And then, my favorite one of all is here, the inspiration, the one that kept everybody alive and going strong, is here today, Jenny Flotis. Stand up, Jenny. Jenny, she may be short in stature. She is short in stature, but she's a giant. She is, as Tomas mentioned, she is director of migrant education for this entire region. Okay, out of Bakersfield City Schools right now. Wasco girl, right? Secondly, I'd like to mention, first I came out of that project that I worked with Jess Nieto, who's also passed on. And that was the Mexica project. And that person was Martin Castro. Martin was a freshman or a sophomore over at BC at the time. He is now president of the Mexican American Opportunity Foundation in LA. Can't be here today because he's in Washington getting funding for that program. But second, third person, Mary Alice Sandoval Bernan. These are just representatives of all of these people that came through. Mary Alice Sandoval Bernard entered the Credential program the hard way, raising three sons and being told that she was a little bit too timid to be a teacher. Well, I want you to know that she's one of the best teachers in Lamont now, been there a long time, and she completed her master's here with two majors, early childhood and bilingual, and she's currently working on completing her doctorate at USC. And still teaching in Lamont. Couldn't be here today because he's testing. Next person, next three people, all of them from the Becca Project. Remain standing for a second, Jane. Would you please? Maria Villarreal. Maria Villarreal is going to join you right now. Maria Villarreal, who is a restorative specialist in Bakersfield City, her sister, Hilda Wright, who's a Bakersfield City and as an instructional specialist. Carlos Arambula, who's a teacher in the Edison School District. Please stand, Carlos. And last person I want to mention is one of the representatives of the MA project that completed his MA. And I could tell the whole story, should I? He's one of the people that didn't finish right away. And every time I ran into him, Home Depot, Target, whatever, I reminded him and he listened and here he is and his name is Pedro Garcia. Please stand. I want you to know that each of these successful graduates is an educator dedicated to improving the lives of their students. Their entire professional careers are devoted to help each of those students to reach their full potential and become productive American citizens. Now, let's give them a big hand. So I thank you for this award on behalf of these educators and the students that they serve. Give me a second. I had a lifelong dream to reach those kids that nobody else cared about. Through them, I feel that that dream has been fulfilled. Thank you very much.
This is your seat. Again, let me flatten all of those.
That's all, thank you. Dean Ash